Hello, this is Kylie JNS. Happy Friday. I hope you guys are having a great week and that you had a great week that was full of productivity and joy. And so here we are with our weekly tarot, as per usual. So we got a lot of cool things to discuss relating to what we talked about last week as we start with our review. We are going to review what we talked about, which was the week, which was October 4th, right? Yes, last Friday was October 4th. We did a reading. We said there would be a couple of things that take place relating to childcare programs, cash infusions, certain things of that nature. And so we want to review what took place to see what transpired, because there may be some things that are relevant for you or even a family member that you know relating to some of the events that took place this week, especially when we're going to discuss this child care stuff that's about to come out, the child pilot programs that's about to come out, as well as even some of the things with FEMA for those who are affected by that unfortunate hurricane. I think there's two now. There was Hurricane Helene and then Hurricane Milton. You know what they do with them weathers. You know, them weather systems. I mean, read between the lines. I mean, it's about to be, I mean, you know what time it is. And so we don't need to go into details. What's known don't need to be said, but my prayers are out for everyone that is affected by this. But, you know, let's keep in mind that they have no problem social engineering cataclysmic events to mold the collective consciousness of people into a certain frequency. And so obviously when we think about like these disasters with the weather, that's to lower that. That's obviously to get people in a state of panic, stress, and fear. And so we have to get in front of what we know their angle is, which we know that's a possibility. You know, we're going to see more of these storms and stuff because that's one way of the manipulation. And so you have to know that and prepare for that through any storm that they may throw at us, quite literally and figuratively, any storm that they throw at us. We are to not be swayed by anything that they do. And before we do this review, because this is very important, because I know there's a lot of people affected by those hurricanes. I'll read you something to get into the review. And, you know, I'm not pushing any religion or anything on anyone, but when we think about like those hurricanes and the way that the impact that they have on people's uprooting of their very lives, you know, things that they didn't plan for, and now they're, you know, unexpected expenses, unexpected travel, unexpected, you know, bullshit, you know, from these storm systems. And so, you know, I want to read Psalms 46 in lieu of that, and then we'll get right into the review. So it says, God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth be removed and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea, though the waters roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with the swelling thereof, Selah. There is a river, the streams whereof shall make glad the city of God, the holy place of the tabernacles of the Most High. God is in the midst of her. She shall not be moved. God shall help her. And that right early. And how you want to read that last part is, God is in the midst of me. I shall not be moved. God shall help me. And that right early. But when we think about like these storms and these hurricanes, though the waters thereof roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with the swelling thereof, it doesn't matter. That's a state of the whatever they're going to do, whatever they're going to manipulate, let it, you know, don't let it affect you. Like I'm by that area that just got, you know, ran through with that situation in Conyers, Georgia. There was an explosion of that lab that happened three times on every election season, mind you. Very, very suspect. But, you know, I live right by there. I'm telling you, like when that stuff happened, you know, they were telling people to evacuate. Then they told people, you know, to shelter in place. And, you know, I knew either I overstand certain things, you know, when it comes to how they put out stories to implant a bug of fear or a bug of panic to get to move a certain frequency. And honestly, with me living so close to that area You know, I got the emergency, you know, we were getting those emergency Amber alert, not Amber alerts, but you know, the emergency things on the phone that says, hey, shelter in place. Hey, if you're in this county, shelter in place has been issued because of the remediation efforts of that. But now they telling you shelter in place and they one for you just told us to evacuate. So which one is it, you know? And so, you know, obviously I think our people are smart enough to realize it ain't playing them games. People going to do whatever they're going to do. If it's going to take you out, the little lab, little thing, experiment going to take you out, we're going to take you out. I mean, we live right near the CDC and shit. It's like, so it's like, whatever they're going to do, it is what it is. But I do have to say, I started feeling, you know, like I remember the day after that had happened or whatever was in that air. Cause I didn't, whatever was in that air, I ain't gonna hold you. That shit, like, and then you don't really know if it was that or if it was something else. But I'm telling you, that next day, I could not get out that bed. I was like, whoa. I mean, I slept. I just couldn't get off the bed. And I'm talking about like that level of tiredness. And sometimes you have metaphysical tiredness, and then sometimes it's like, okay, it's like some type of gas. Like it was like something in that air. It felt like it. And that could have just been, you know, the placebo effect. Oh, you know, you're thinking it and then, you know, you manifest that. But no, not getting out the bed like that. Not where I just, And that was the day after that had happened. And so, I mean, I'm not like when I say near the lab, I'm not saying I'm like walking distance, but I'm saying like it's close enough. Like I'm almost positive that where I'm located and where that lab is, it wouldn't be far-fetched that smoke reached over here. And plus there was a lot of people in Georgia saying they could smell that chlorine and they could smell all that stuff. But again, it's meant to mold your frequency too. Like throwing that out there in the news, and they do that every 4 years. I mean, and it's happened 3 times already. That's to mess with your frequency. That's to mess with your mind. If ain't nothing happened in 2016 and ain't nothing happened in 2020 and ain't nothing happened in 2024, I would just go out and buy my business. That's how I approached it when I heard it. I'm like, okay, they fucking around with stuff. And then I heard it happen 3 times. I just didn't give a shit. I'm like, if it's going to take me out, it's going to take me out. Because I done seen miracles. I mean, but where my mind is at, I'm telling you, my mind has been through the worst of the worst. And I know that when you think you about to die or you thinking that you could take yourself out or whatever you're going to do. And I know if it's meant for your ass to be alive and be here, you're going to be alive and you're going to be here. And that's what I know for a fact. I don't care if you could try to poison a person. Like that story they talk about, Abednego and Mishrak and all that shit in the book of Daniel when they had them in that fire and they wasn't burning. I definitely believe stuff like that can happen after even what I know what I've been through. And so I don't care if it's big ass smokes. They telling us, oh, you got to leave. Oh, it's going to take you out. You got to evacuate. You got to do this. If it's going to do it, then it's going to do it. If not, it's not. And if something happened and I know, and you know, I didn't have nowhere to go. And you know, I didn't have the funds. I'll sue a motherfucker. Shit. If something do happen, but like, I'm not getting worked up over some shenanigans that y'all done orchestrated that y'all pull. I'm not getting worked up in fear off of y'all narrative that y'all trying to script right and get all Black Americans. It's nothing but Black Americans in that area where that lab explosion. And so I'm like, y'all trying to get people to evacuate. Why? Because they praying too much? Why? Because of the frequency is too high in that area? I mean, you got to start to think of things of when they want people to move and then they tell you to shelter and then they tell you to you can't do this and they want you to lock down. What you got to ask yourself why they want all of that to control somebody. That's mind control. That's frequency control. And so you do whatever you want. I'm a homebody. I ain't going to hold you. I like the home. And that's something I got to work on as far as getting out more. I've always been that way. I've been that way since I was a little ass kid. I always was a shelter in place motherfucker anyways. But that's my thing. I don't project what I do on what other motherfuckers want to do. There's people that can't stay in the house. They got to be outside. They got to run the streets. They got to rip and run them streets. They got to be outside. It is what it is. And they had that right. And so when they tell them motherfuckers that you got to stay in your house and shit, no, that it's not, it's people are not built like that. Just because I've been programmed a certain way, and that could be something in my childhood that I got to work through, because I like to be at home. But the motherfuckers that like to be outside or like to do, I would say keep doing what you're doing. Do whatever you want to do. Don't listen to nothing. Like, I'm telling you, don't rest in man's understanding on things, because they don't be knowing what they be talking about, these people. And so if they telling you you got to stay locked up inside and you know that's not what you want to do, then don't do it. Because if that smoke was going to take you out, it would have took you out already. It already happened 3 times in the span of 12 years. So whatever they want to release around a certain time, whatever that smoke is to mess with your frequency anyways. And so whatever we are inhaling, I'm telling you, like, I got sick from that, whatever that was. And I'm still recovering, you know? And then the thing is like, okay, you know, it could have been another factor or variable that caused whatever, you know, but I know the day after, I know I was done for. I was like, what the hell is that? And I did close the window because I had it open and I said, well, let me close the window, you know, let me turn off the air conditioner, you know, all that stuff. But that's what they do. That's what them people be playing them games. And if you know that you want to continue whatever you was doing, that's what they already hit us with that during in 2020. And that messed my mind up because I totally, you know, was scared when that pandemic happened. I wasn't goofy enough to take that shot though. I wasn't gonna do that. Now that's a bridge too far. But when I you know, they mess with people's frequency by putting that type of news and stuff like that out. So just be careful. But let's get into the review. Most importantly, because we got some cool things we want to discuss. And so we mentioned last week that there would be potential things with alliances, a stimulus infusion. We were hoping that it would be something for the victims of the hurricane. They've seen things with new programs relating to children that could have been like humanitarian things relating to children or programs. And so we've seen that. And so let's review it and then we'll discuss what we saw. For next week. And again, you guys can go on my website or on Etsy if you want to book a personal reading with me. You schedule it in a professional manner, you know, what time.
Let me fast forward just a little bit because I thought I want to get straight into it.
Like some alliances, we're talking about global events now. We're going to start with some global and then we're going to get into individual. But definitely alliances of some sort what could be built this week between three people or two people. Or two, you know, obviously when we say people, these could be institutions, they could be countries, but we're looking at like an alliance of some major alliance forms that is win-win for everybody involved, either between two entities or three. I also see for the global, there could be some sort of infusion of cash. It's like some type of infusion of cash for people. I hope that this is relating to the Helene.
Okay, so I'm going to pause. So when we talk about like alliances, I mean, there was quite a bit of discussion of alliances this week. This was just a day ago, as you can see. I just went to Google and typed in alliance. So there is a discussion between alliance between NATO and Trump. And so we'll see what that is. It says Trump will need NATO if elected. So there's some new alliance chief. They're discussing that. There's alliances between Haas and Toyota. But that's more like a company, though. But I was looking to see if there was something. Yeah, so it's something with NATO. This keeps coming up, as you can see. This is a day ago. NATO will begin its nuclear exercise alliance, Secretary General Mark said. Okay, so look at this. This is 22 hours ago. This is yesterday. It says the U.S.-Japan security alliance is growing more integrated. Okay. So that was something with alliances. Something with NATO could come up, but I mean, I feel like this energy is still unfolding. It felt very minor, though. But let's look at this cash infusion thing, because that's pretty cool, right? And so we didn't get quite like this cash infusion that I was looking for when it comes to FEMA, because I was hoping it might have been FEMA with the hurricane thing. We do know that the DOD, and this is, I'll share to you, this is October 7th, maybe this one. This one is the Department of Defense did increase support for Hurricane Helene response efforts. That was on October 7th. And so there's a infusion of resources, but not necessarily the cash is what we were looking for. It says the Defense Department is continuing to increase support for local, state, and federal emergency responders. And so that part, that part sort of came to pass. But let me show you this, because I did say I was hoping for it was for the Helene
over there in FEMA. I mean, you know, the victims in North Carolina that's been impacted by the hurricane FEMA. I'm hoping that there's an infusion of cash where the American citizens can get more than $750. It just looks like something with an infusion. I can't see it as anything other than that right now, but I do see if it's not relating to Hurricane Helene, we'll have to just, you know, state that next week. But
okay, so we see the increase in the resources, but I don't see anything that says cash for the FEMA. It says nearly 1,000 soldiers have been mobilized. Okay. Okay, looking for the resources. Okay, and so we see that that support for Hurricane Helene responses, but it has to be something else. So it's making post-disaster mitigation less expensive for applicants. So this was October 9th. So that was 2 days ago. So let's see what this is. With disasters increasing in frequency, severity, and cost, the FEMA has a new financial incentive for applicants to rebuild in ways that will make them more resilient in the face of a future event. FEMA will increase its public assistance federal cost share for projects that incorporate poor post-disaster recovery measures, including readiness for and resilience from a future major disaster. Okay, this cost share incentive applies to Hurricane Helene's permanent work projects. Section 406, Robert Stafford Disaster Relief and Emergency Assistance. Okay. To provide public assistance grants for the repair replacement of facilities damaged by the major disaster. Okay, so FEMA will apply cost share increases as follow. If the total cost of our project, okay, so this is, we were hoping to get something for the actual American people, but it does look like there is something relating to FEMA increasing the incentive for these for mitigation measures. And so, I mean, it's a start. It's something. But I do still want to push as far as probability distribution science and HECA, we want to still push for cash infusion relating to disaster relief and people getting their lives put back together. And so we do see some resources. This week, we did see resources increase, and we do see FEMA making post-disaster mitigation less expensive for applicants, and that relates to mitigation measures. So I guess that would be agencies and nonprofits and infrastructure providers to they'll have grants and they'll have funding to put things back together quicker. And that to me doesn't seem like it would be enough, but I mean, we'll see. But another cool thing that we did see though, as far as like this cash infusion, look at this, China, it was global. And I always thought this was gonna be for the US, but it was China. Look at this. China's bold cash infusion lifts stock markets higher. They did a cash infusion this week. China did. I wanted this to be America, but China did. China did a massive $70 billion liquidity injection, causing the stock in Hong Kong to soar. So, you know, maybe this is what I was picking up. You saw me say something with cash infusion. That was just last week. This is a day ago. I just thought that this would be more so for America, and I was really trying to push that energy for America. But China beat America to it. They did the cash infusion. And look at this, when we say stimulus, China's stock market, it did tumble a bit too, because they also did a government stimulus. And this was, we did our video October 4th. They did they shit that Saturday. I'm telling you, we put our stuff out there on Friday, and these you know, bankers and whoever, you know, whoever may pick up on the energy, or somebody, these warlocks, whoever's watching that video, they'd jump on it and be like, you know what, okay. But I really, really thought that it would be America to do this stimulus. But China did a stimulus, a cash infusion, and it made their markets go higher. They've tumbled at first, and then it inevitably made it go higher, though. Dang, I thought that would be America. I was hoping. But I do still think that there's going to be more relief or something with an infusion. I'm still actually going to look for it, because I still feel like there's something along the lines that could come still, you know. So let's keep going, because we did mention something about the child care, and it was a lot of things that took place with child care. But there's some sort of infusion of cash, if it's like a surplus or something that gives some stimulus. So I don't know if they're going to announce some sort of stimulus.
So it was China that did their stimulus this week.
Maybe it's just for the victims of that hurricane, some type of stimulus or something. That's the first thing that keep coming to my mind. Stimulus. Let me write this down, actually. Stimulus. I get an infusion in cash. I'm hoping that this is for those victims. For the victims, or so let's see, maybe from I'm getting that it doesn't seem quite foreign. I wouldn't rule that out, because you can never rule anything out, but I'm just saying it don't quite feel like a
foreign. It was foreign. It was China.
But this seems something more in-house, more national.
Well, then FEMA announced, you know, they gave more resources, but that's not necessarily the same thing as a cash infusion.
Whatever this is, but it's to like give like cash like to people, like that's what it is, like that's why I'm thinking it got to be like maybe some type of relief or some relief fund for a certain segment or for a certain population. I don't think it's gonna be, it may not be all of Americans. I wish it was, but another thing, we see like a three-way alliance announcement or two-way. Alliance, or like what's it called, conglomeration, or not conglomeration, is that a mergers or something? But it's like that, and it could be with countries or people or institutions. That's what I'm saying. But it's major, and it is fruitful. It does seem to be possibly long term. And it could relate to investment world. The first thing that keep popping up is the investment world, but I'm hoping that, it could be something a little more serious, but the first thing that keep coming up is the investment world. So I'll put that in there just in case.
So that was China's stock, because it said China's market soared. That cash infusion helped they stock market, but it's, I think that Alliance thing was more so something that they planning with, with our government and NATO, so we have to still see about that.
I see anything else? It's a great week for healing. It's a great week for any type of healing, any type of apologies that need to be mailed out. It's a great week for any sort of long-term planning for life. As far as this week, say if you needed to update any sort of thing, like in lieu of what we saw with James, we needed to update any sort of trust, will, living will, whatever it is. This is an investment. You want to look at whatever it is, beneficiaries. This is a good week to handle that as well. The money also looks great. If you're working,
You may notice, again, for those that are working on it, this week, it looks great in terms of, like, say, especially if you're in management, if you're in any sort of management, whatever needed to be balanced in terms of the finances, it's going to go excellent. You may want to pay attention to the plans early on. That's the first thing I get. Let me look some more into this. Also, it's a great week for philanthropy and humanitarian work. We may actually see something with philanthropy or humanitarian relating to children. Let me put that in here. That just comes up for some reason. Philanthropy or humanitarian work relating to children. And that kind of looks to be more something like global. Maybe that's a new program that's announced. Maybe a program to help of children for whatever.
Okay, so a program to help children. So there was quite a bit, as we can see, this was October 9th as well. The DOD rolled out child care reimbursement test program. So this is a pilot program. There was a couple of pilot programs that came out this week. But if you notice, pay attention for the Americans that can read between in line. When we talk about the DOD and they're rolling out these programs, that's the second program that they rolled out. That's to let you know what's going on in terms of who's really in charge and what's going on. But read bigger in between the lines. I have to speak in code in my tarot videos. My other videos, not so much, but in my tarot videos, I do. For algorithmic purposes. But when you think about, I just shared the stuff with FEMA and you saw who was behind Infusion allocating the resources for that. And then you see them roll out the child care reimbursement test program. That was October 9th. Okay. And so this is something you want to look into is the child care. If you're in the military, this is something that you may want to look into because it's reimbursement for the travel of temporary child care. So this is something you want to research on your own. If you're in Air Force, Army, Coast Guard, Marine Corps, Navy, I think even this is for Space Force as well, if I read that right earlier. So it says those eligible may get reimbursed up to $1,500 for travel of that child care provider to or from overseas and up to $500 for travel within domestic locations, okay? And so that's something you want to look up. If you know that you're in the military and you know you have children, this is something you may want to take advantage of. Depending on eligible for the program. Okay, so that just came out, but look at this. There was a lot of stuff relating to like children program, but this is another pilot program that came out. Or is this the same pilot program? This was October 10th. Oh, so this looks like it's the same pilot program that we talked about. Pilot program covers certain childcare costs after PCS move. October 10th, 2024. You see it on your screen, which we just covered that. But so this is just to let you guys know to jump on it. Okay, jump on. It's a 3-year program. Okay. Here's another program that's about to start. This is another one you guys want to look into. So there was a $30 million that was approved to expand child care for low-income families across Harris County. So this was October 8th. So you have to be in Texas, but there's an additional $30 million in funding for the Early Reach Program now combined to support 800 to 1,000 slots for children under 4 years old. And so you want to, once again, jump on it. On Tuesday, county commissioners approved the additional $30 million for the rescue plan funding for the program. So if you're in that Texas area, so again, you got securing the program until 2026. The funding passed, and it's up into 2026. And so let's see if there's more programs like this. Let's see if there's more child. Let me see. Let me just type in because it you know, usually, you know, could be something that's like more than just one area, child care programs. Okay, so let's see. Okay, so there's something in Washington State too. If you guys can see it right here. Look at this. You have to jump on these things. You see it right in front of your screen. We're using probability distribution science to push these things. You just see me say stuff with children, and the next week, look at this. Child care subsidies expanding for some Washington families starting next month. Eligible families across Washington will gain access to new state child care subsidies to help recover costs. Now, we did our video October 4th. This is just 3 days ago. Let's look at this. I didn't even see this. This is October 7th. So if you're in Washington, you want to go and look at these things. It's for infants to three-year-olds, will provide full day care for eligible children paid for by the state or federal government. Starting November 1st, enrollment in those support services count as eligible work activity towards receiving Working Connections child care program subsidies. So what do? You go and you research and you go and you sign up if this applies to you. You get on it early. Look at this. This is for Massachusetts. State grants help child care providers. This is also 7 hours ago. Go on there and go. And if you're in Massachusetts, look at these things. Or just Google wherever state you're in and then type in or county you're in, child care services and or child programs. Okay? And so these are some of these grants. Okay, have now been made permanent in the state's 2025 fiscal year budget as a win for many in the early childhood education sector. Stockbridge program. Okay, so it's permanently added for the fiscal 2025 year budget. Formula for funding. So I don't know about all of that. I'm just saying, we saw something that was going to be big with kids last week, though. I saw something with this kid shit. So it makes sense. Okay. And so that's one thing. I thought that was interesting. But if you're in Washington, Massachusetts, Texas, you want to start. And even up until next week, because remember, this energy lasts for about 2 weeks. So even though we didn't see if you don't see your state or for this week, still look into it for next week, though. Like literally type Google your county or whatever and type in child care program, new child care or child care services, something of that, because I'm telling you, this energies when we push these things out, this probability distribution out like that, it lasts for 2 weeks. So let's see any county that you're in. Let's just do, for instance, let's just see Georgia child care program. And so we didn't see anything specific for Georgia yet, but keep looking. Child care. And so let's see if it's a voucher or something. And so we didn't see anything for this week for Georgia, but like keep looking even into next week. I was hoping maybe there'd be something. Because it's going to be like that, I would say, going in, it's going to be, we got Massachusetts, Washington, and then Texas, and the DOD, Department of Defense, is rolling out their child care reimbursement test pilot program. For that's going to be for 3 years. So if you're in the military, that's also going to help. And that transcends just Texas, obviously. Is there anything else? They saying... Okay. Okay, so look at this. Mental health support for toddlers have lagged in Texas. That's now changing. That was 2 days ago. Senate approves child care tax credit. House has squashed justice. Other child care. That was just yesterday. That's in West Virginia. So yeah, there's a child care crisis, and you know, people are aware of that because people have to work. That's why, you know, with women, you know, and I would even, you know, this is, I want to do a whole series on like UBI, because as far as how this could be dulled out, because maybe this could be something as far as this UBI thing, maybe it's just for women and children. You know, women have to take care of these children. They should be watching their own kids, you know, and especially, you know, maybe the UBI is just for the women, you know, so that they can rely, focus more on family rearing. That could be something, or everybody get the UBI. I'm not opposed to everybody getting a UBI. I ain't trying to, you know what I mean? But I'm just saying, like, we know there's child care crisis and stuff. there's even marriage crisis, there's even family crisis. Like they saying 50% of women are going to be single within the next couple of years because it's no incentive for marriage. Childcare is so expensive. So even if both parents got to work, male and female got to work, and they be talking about $2,000, $3,000 just on childcare. And then they got housing, you know? And so a lot of people are kind of like, you know what? I don't want to have no kids because I ain't gonna be able to afford the childcare, you know? And so that's something to think about as far as like, okay, do we give the, if we, because I know UBI is coming. So it's like, do we give the UBI to women, you know? And that will help considerably, especially for women that need to stay, that will give an incentive for women to think more family oriented, because now they don't have to pay all this money for childcare. They can actually raise their child. They can have incentives to get married, you know, because they know, okay, they know this UBI is coming in. They can actually chill and plan a family now, you know? And then you maybe the UBI is just for women. Maybe it's for male and female. But you know, just to, even if we did want to bring back like these ideas of family orientation and where the man is working and the man is at a house or whatever, and the woman gets the UBI, childcare is very expensive. It's very, very expensive. And so there has to be incentive. There has to be things around this. And, you know, a lot of elements of this country is free falling. I can see it spiritually. And it's because there's more concern with holding on to power in a corrupt order versus just good governance, good government, good governance of an empire. And until we do that, until there's actual like presidential material, governance material on all levels, and not just mere puppets, then you're going to have severe problems in this country. They know that. I know that. The powers that be know that. There was supposed to be some things that went differently. Had certain people play ball, had they didn't play ball, had people been willing to work with one another in a fair manner, instead of this obsession with control, then there were things would be a lot different, at least for the next 4 years. It's going to be different these next 4 years. You're going to see some things. Hopefully things transition smooth into 2028, 2032, but childcare is important. There's ways to mitigate this. Obviously, I don't know how much subsidies we have to even put on childcare, or should there be women actually staying home with their fucking kids and you know, but they have to work. And so that's why I think that's where the UBI could come in. And that should be for women, period. Like I personally don't, you know, I don't think women should be working unless they want to. That's just me. I don't think women should be working unless they damn want to. But you know, these are things we all have to discuss. Like, how do we want to do everybody get the UBI? Do you just give it to women and men are still working? Do you give it to everybody? Do you give it to certain fields that's more vulnerable than others? Or is it just a pilot program for a certain amount of years to get people caught up for their retirement? Like how I talked about a step up program, you know, those type of things. We have to see. And so let's see, we got a couple of things. The legislators hurricane, like childcare funding. Vermont Act 76 gives family access to reduce child care costs. That's in Vermont. So that's Act 76. Income eligibility for the state child care tuition assistance program will increase to include thousands of additional. That was 3 days ago. You want to get on that? So there's a new program covers certain military move child care costs. Okay, so I think we already covered that one. Okay, and so that was for this week. Again, keep looking into next week as well, as far as the childcare stuff, and make sure you Google it. Make sure you you Google your county or whatever, and to see about those resources, or even stimulus and cash infusion. Do that one as well, because there still could be something coming out with that stuff. So let's look into next week. Let's look to see what's the energy for next week. I hope that is something good, you know. I really do. Okay, energy for next week. Okay. Ooh, okay. Let me get it ready for you. The first thing that comes to my mind for next week, let me talk right now because I want to still channel this energy. Okay, let me share my screen so you can see it. The first thing that comes to my mind is secret surprise. I don't know why the hell that comes to my mind. Secret surprise or secret reveal. I don't know. Like the first thing that comes to my mind is secret surprise. And the energy looks good though for this week, I have to say. Or it's a good week to follow your damn intuition, that's for sure. Any gut instinct you have, I'm telling you, follow it. You'll be dead on the money. Yeah, for global events, the main thing that keeps coming up is like some sort of secret surprise or secret revealed that ultimately this could be something that's like somebody that's well intentioned but does not deliver as promised. So this could be the energy is something with looking under the hood again, like fluff, checking, you know, I don't know why that, yeah, it's something, it's like the energy of all that glitters is not gold or something. Yeah. It's something where something under the hood, secret reveal, secret surprise. Now, if there's a secret reveal, it doesn't look like it's something that could be like world shattering, but again, it's just probability distribution, so you can't rule out anything. This is a database of information that we're looking at. And so I would say this one is a challenging one. I wonder if it's a secret revealed about a male. Well intentioned, but does not deliver as promised. This could be a male. This could be a male. I hope that or a secret surprise could be something in the collective sense, like something that's revealed to humanity. Could be that as well. Another thing that I see is it could perhaps revelations or. Revelation about state of economy in terms of finances that come to light. Something comes to light. To be honest, this is like budgetary issues, but it's something that is kind of jarring, but it looks like the public's reaction to it is like something they already knew. Intuitively, it's something they knew subconsciously, so it's not as it won't be as much panic as people may think. Whatever this is coming out, whatever this is, this reveal, this revelation of whatever comes out, it's kind of like, well, shit, we already kind of knew, whatever. It's kind of like that type of vibe, whatever this is. If it's a negative thing, that would be the reaction. Is that, oh well, on a positive on a positive note, though, this could actually be something that's very, that whatever the revelation is, it could be something that's good. So we're going to be looking for like revelation, secret reveal, secret surprise, that could relate to a male, or this could relate to the state of the economy in terms of budgetary affairs, or start realizing like we're juggling resources to keep afloat. Something's not as secure as one thought, something with mounting debts or not being financially secure, or exploit. So it was like, this could be like exploring some sort of partnerships to ease financial worries, or exploring an avenue rather. I won't say necessarily partnerships, but though I wouldn't roll that out because this seems to be like more governmental, this energy I'm feeling, or like national. Like if it's not governmental, it's like it's something national. And again, I can't say that's just for America, but it's exploring an avenue to ease financial worries. Now this could be a government or a bank. Is bailout the right word to come out? Bailout? I don't know. We'll see. It's interesting though. So we're going to be looking for that because that's kind of heavy. that one was kind of like throwing me off because I'm like, how do I interpret this spread, you know, this energy? Because it's not entirely negative. Again, there's a lot of intuition in this. And so if this week is a great week for you're knowing intuitively what to do, you want to follow your gut instinct. If you need to retreat from social life, you may feel like that this week. Now let's go into individual. Tap into that, the power of yourself this week. And many of you may be trying to think about, you may feel like, okay, things about like counseling or therapy, like that stuff may come up this week. Either if you have a session, it will go great. If you have a therapy session, that's going to go great, counseling session. Or if you have been thinking about, you may be thinking about it more than usual. That's something to take into account. You know, if you start to feel like that, like, okay, things of spirituality may come up this week as well in your personal life as far as getting guidance. But another thing for the individual self is that there's going to be like a feeling of a sense of accomplishment. And so you may feel like in your work ethic and your work, there's like a victory, you know, or you may actually get some sort of reward, even if it's a small scale reward. It could be something on the job. So it could be an actual reward from any avenue, but it does look to be related to an accomplishment of yours. So even if it's a recognition of some sort, I do see like that energy for this week as well. You're feeling at the top of your game. It's a good week for any negotiations, taking initiative and being resourceful, okay? And being a problem solver. That's going to also be the energy that you have. It's a good week. In the beginning of the week, though, the only precaution, though, is that if you start to feel like a little boredom or apathy, just realize that you know, maybe you may want to practice some gratitude if you start to feel that. And also realize that you're on the right path and that what you need is right in front of you. If you start to feel a little withdrawn or a little depressed, that energy is early in the week, though, like tomorrow, Sunday or Monday. And so it's temporary. If you start feeling a little bit like a boredom or a depression or a little bit, but just snap yourself out of it very quickly. You could do that with gratitude. And if you have any passion projects that you're working on, you know, you may want to distract yourself with your passion projects to get out of that brief funk of whatever that feeling is. But overall, it does look like a good, peaceful week. From what I'm seeing, I don't see anything that's alarming on here. Maybe a delay in travel if you're traveling, you know, make sure you pay attention to any delays and whatnot. But other than that, everything looks good. And so we'll come back next week to do a review, see if we see some things globally that transpire. And that's going to be the 18th. So we'll be back on October 18th to do the review of this week and see if we see, you know, anything relating to secret revelations and secret surprises. You know, what kind of revelations did we get about the economy? Let's see if there is going to be explore an avenue to ease financial worries. Let's see what comes to light. And again, I still may look at something with the child care stuff. Something that energy was still very prevalent into next week. And so I'm going to leave that in there as well. The child care program. We just want to see a little bit more of that, possibly on the national level. I'm not going to roll out that cash infusion either. I'm not going to roll that out either into next week, because sometimes it can take 2 weeks, but I just, you know, I'm experimenting with this myself. You know, we're doing probability distribution science, which is a combination of predictive programming, script writing, and divination under the guise of tarot. And so we're learning as we go, but we've been uncannily accurate for the last, it's been 7 months now, 8 months now. And so we'll continue to do these things. But again, when we look at these programs, them new programs, like them housing ones, like that video about the housing, I know y'all got to jump on these things early. Like some of these programs are not even out yet, that apprenticeship stuff. Like that's, they're putting the funding for these stuff together. You want to look at your state, look at it and jump on it. So we got apprenticeships, housing, stuff with childcare. You have to jump on these things early. My channel is shadow banned. You guys know I don't have a big audience. So those who get to see these things, you're in for a treat, because this stuff is not going to be on the mainstream. You know, like when we talk about like those housing program, that video with the tarot video with the housing and the tarot video with the apprenticeships. And it's been a couple of things. I remember one time we saw that there was going to be a glitch in child payment, a glitch in a benefit program. We saw it that Monday. There was a massive glitch that affected 1 million people in this country for their child care benefits. It was people that had to go to the pantry, Americans. And so I saw that literally 3 days before it happened, and it's recorded and documented. And so, you know, that's why this stuff, they don't want this stuff to get out, because people would plan in advance. People would start to be like, yo, what this child, you know, they probably would have went to the damn pantry if they knew they was waiting on that big payment. A benefit payment that didn't, they had a glitch in their system. I told them to have a glitch in their system. Did they listen? No. But that's what they do. You know, if they, we could do it the easy way or the hard way, you know, and they sit up there and play around with these people. They, again, I'm telling you, a lot of the things that I've said have come to pass. And we talk about this change of guard and the change of guard going to a specific bloodline. I've been saying that since 2022 at the behest of even looking all crazy. But as we see more and more and more, you guys are going to see it more and more and more, that there is something severely not right with the way the current governance is going, that something is empty. Now, read between the lines. We just saw this. The DOD is the one rolling out these programs. Read between the lines. They are rolling out child care programs. The DOD. They rolled out the FEMA stuff. And so that should let you know that there's a major change of guard. There is a lot of standoffs. There is a lot of like what's going on, because it's an order that's being ushered in. And there's an order that's changing, and there's an order that's going to fight to the death. And so things are looking a little shaky in America. I mean, they only give them motherfuckers $750. You know what I mean? And people need more than that after the hurricane disaster. It's a lot of weather systems acting up. You know, it's a lot of distractions. It's a lot of stuff. We see this shake up with Hollywood, which I told y'all in December 2023 that was going to happen. It was the year of exposure. And I had already told y'all that we was changing this dimension, that treaty is up. That treaty is up. And so I don't care how I sound. When we talk about the treaty, we're talking about a treaty of governance, of a time of bloodline families that had that treaty, that treaty is no longer active. It's not being recognized on any dimensional level. And it has to go to that right now. If they don't want to give it, you know, the rightful heir knows, we know who the family is, the bloodline is, but, you know, we needed more time. But at the same time, it's like,
it's gonna get a little shaky before it gets better. And it's like you kind of have to flex a little, and you'd be wanting things to go smooth and transition smoothly for everybody, you know. But you can't take people's kindness for weakness, and you know, because just because the person is very kind, and it doesn't mean switching bait on them, it doesn't mean sabotage or still use a deceptive tactic to see how you gonna finagle or finesse something. I can sense that energy being done in this country, and I'm letting you know that I'm aware of it, and it's not gonna work. It's not going to work. I'm very benevolent, but I'm not going to take too kindly to someone trying to play on my top. And so I say that to say we want things to just be fair and run smoothly. And I can sense spiritually that there's like a lot of vacancy. And at the last of what we're dealing with is a quest, is illegitimate power, is what I'll say. There's illegitimate authorities, there's illegitimate power, and the public is not aware of it. Those at the highest levels are aware of what I'm talking about, though. And that illegitimacy is transcending beyond just 3D, 5D shit. And so it will become soon apparent to the American people what I'm talking about. Right now, it's very cryptic. Right now, it's like, what? But that feeling, I remember I was reading a forum, and it was some Americans that felt like, how come it just feels like there's illegitimacy? And I'm not talking about any government or anything of that nature. I'm talking spiritually. Like this this quest to hold on to something that's not legitimately theirs. That energy that you sense spiritually that Americans were talking about, your gut is on to something. Like if you feel that, like don't ignore that. There's something to that. This illegitimacy of a bloodline or somebody trying to steal something that's just not theirs, or keep something that never belonged to them to begin with. They're trying to hold on to something that was never theirs to begin with. It was never rightfully theirs. And it was only borrowed for a time. And so I've sensed that what I feel will become more apparent to people. So we'll be back next week. Okay. And so you guys have a great week. And love you. Talk to you later. Bye.